Oh yeah, 213 Rock, Final Times, The Classic Rock Radio, en direct ce soir, Mr. Mike Stanley of Dark Tranquility, yeah. Hi Mike, yes. Nice to meet you, how are you?
Hey, I'm great, I'm awesome, I just arrived home late last night from a fantastic festival tour in Italy and Germany, and I'm France? Back home and it feels good, and now I'm,
Yeah,
sitting on the phone here, talking to a lot of cool people like you.
Ok, donc Mike est juste rentré de tournée hier soir, cette nuit en tout cas, on va dire, on va préciser. Effectivement, il a fait un petit peu le tour de l'Europe. Il a joué la semaine passée au Hellfest, hein. Effectivement, c'était un show énorme. On va en parler d'ici quelques instants. Et puis, donc, il est très heureux d'être avec nous ce soir en direct. Il a une journée promotionnelle aussi très, très chargée. So, Mike, as you know, the name of the show is 213 Rock, hosted by Vinyl Times, the classic rock radio. As you know, we are based in Paris, France. And the new album of the band called End Time Signals will be out the next August 16 through Century Media Records.
Yes, that's happening.
Yes, that's happening. I think you are the most busiest man, artist, actually, in Europe. Yeah. Free bands.
Not sure about that, but yeah, it's a busy times for sure. And what did I do to myself? I don't know. Maybe I'm starting to regret saying yes to a lot of things.
Effectivement, en ce moment, il est très, très chargé, hein, puisqu'il y a le nouvel album, donc le 16 août prochain des Dark Tranquility, et il est aussi sur Cemetery Skyline, et puis il est aussi The Halo Effect. Voilà, c'est ça, c'est The Halo Effect. Il travaille dessus, en tout cas, et je peux vous dire, c'est l'homme le plus chargé en ce moment en termes de travail. C'est vraiment incroyable. Puis ces trois groupes-là, ça fonctionne. C'est ça qui est extraordinaire. So, Mike, how do you feel about Hellfest last week?
Oh, it was awesome. It was absolutely fantastic. Like, it's, I mean, yeah, we haven't been there since 19, I think it was, and that was fantastic, but this was even better, and everything just worked out. The crowd was incredible. It was the first day of the festival, so you could tell, like, people were hungry, you know. We managed to meet a lot of friends. I saw some fantastic shows. Just an overall fantastic time. There's no better festival anywhere, in my opinion. Like, it doesn't, no one comes even close. And it just, it was incredible. Like, I wish I could stay. I really wanted to stay for a couple more days, but that didn't work. Hopefully next year.
Okay. Alors, effectivement, pour lui, le Hellfest est certainement le meilleur festival metal au monde. Il voulait rester quelques jours de plus. Bon, finalement, il pouvait pas parce qu'il a il a quand même des concerts à assurer. Il a rencontré plein de gens, plein d'amis. Le public était juste énorme. Le show par rapport à celui de 2018 était nettement meilleur, c'était fantastique en tout cas, et c'était incroyable. And your show on the altar stage was absolutely success.
Oh yeah.
I saw some a couple of videos available on YouTube. Yeah, like,
okay.
Like a track Atoma, the atmosphere was very hot.
It really was. It was fantastic to see. And, you know, we know that it's great. We played there a few times. Maybe this was our fifth or sixth time at Hellfest. But, man, like, you're still not really prepared for what's coming at you. And it's, I don't know, there's such a special vibe at that festival that it's a beautiful thing to behold from us.
Mm-hmm, effectivement, on n'est jamais préparé pour savoir ce qui va arriver au Hellfest. C'est quand même la sixième fois. C'est toujours fou à chaque fois. Ça monte toujours de niveau. Et puis, la vibe, elle est là, quoi. Et puis, avec la relation avec les fans qui chantaient, qui sautaient de partout, c'était incroyable, quoi. And Mike, Hellfest was the time to present three new songs on the setlist for your next album, End Time Signals, available, as I said, August 16. 4 months ago, the first track was The Last Imagination, came out with a new music video, because is really in the world that we live in.
Yeah, that was part of the appeal of kind of doing like an animated first video, because I think what Niklas did with the cover art for this album is really, really spectacular, and has this, the inspiration comes from kind of old animated kids shows that we saw when we were kids that came out of Eastern Europe, like Czechoslovakia had this kind of almost kind of like puppet show, but it was kind of like very crude animation, but it told really serious stories, but it was meant for kids, but there was always something creepy about it, like something underlying that you couldn't really put your finger on, but it affected us very much. And when we started thinking about how to portray this new album visually, like, that kind of came to mind. And I think that's why I think that the album looks fantastic, but also the video kind of showcases this idea that, you know, you can tell a very grim and kind of a dark dystopian story but doing it in a way that that is not 100% depressing, but you know, in a different way. And that was a challenge, and it's something cool that that we really loved about this album.
Effectivement, que cet album, déjà la musique vidéo, toute la version dessin animé, franchement, est superbe. Hein. C'est aussi la même personne qui a réalisé l'artwork. Ça, c'est fantastique. Et puis l'inspiration vient lorsqu'il était plus jeune. Il a visité des pays tels que la Tchécoslovaquie, enfin tous les pays de l'Est. En tout cas, il connaît par cœur. Il a été affecté à l'époque dans les années 70, enfin 80 surtout, de la situation économique de ces pays. Ça lui a rappelé effectivement la composition donc de ce nouvel album sur la condition humaine. En tout cas, c'est un peu ça qu'il essayait de nous expliquer. Il a été affecté par ça. Et puis l'album est d'un côté très dark, avec ce côté dystopian et ces histoires assez sérieuses, quoi. C'était un véritable challenge pour lui, hein. Because the lyrics are very dark, Mike. Yeah. As you sing, this is the last page of the story no one else will ever read.
Yeah, I think for some reason, which may be kind of obvious, I think the last couple of years have been rough for us all. after the pandemic, at least I thought that maybe like a unifying, like on a global phenomenon like that would bring us together, but it turned out the opposite kind of was true. And there is more misery in the world now than it was during that time, which is just crazy. And as much as I have liked to think that I've been optimistic most of my life, where I figured like, yeah, it's going to be fine. You know, we get over it, we get past it, we learn from it, and we move on. But I haven't really felt that lately. I think I felt quite the opposite, and it's been kind of rough. And we decided, like me and Martin and Johan, when we started writing this, that maybe we should kind of give in to those feelings of despair and helplessness and frustration, and not, you know, kind of sugarcoat it, get around it. So it became kind of like this. I had this, you know, this dystopian idea of what's the worst that can happen, you know, if we don't stop it, where would it lead, you know, and if whatever happens now is unchecked and scrutinized, then what will happen, you know, if we kind of lose our sense of direction. And it was kind of like a scary thought, and I think in many ways it's becoming true. And so I just wanted to get that out of my system lyrically, and also for the music. We just wanted to write like the most dark and dystopian album we could ever make, and so that's what we set out to do.
Ok, alors avec cette longue réponse, effectivement, on va essayer d'en résumer un petit peu. Donc c'est avec les années qu'on a vécu quand même. Hein, on a vécu la pandémie, effectivement, toutes ces histoires de guerre et tout, de misère. Ça se développe un petit peu donc à travers en Europe. Hein, il a remarqué que tous les systèmes économiques en ce moment sont un peu en berne. Donc lui, il essaye de rester optimiste. Alors effectivement, ils ont écrit avec le groupe, avec Johan et le reste des membres du groupe, ils ont essayé d'écrire un album assez sombre, mais vraiment très sombre, quoi, qui parle justement de tout ça, qui ils expriment, en tout cas c'est vraiment basé sur la condition humaine, c'est vraiment ce qu'ils vivent au quotidien, et c'est pour ça que les paroles, elles sont très dark, elles sont très dures. Lorsque vous écouterez l'album, vous n'hésitez pas à comparer ça avec les lyrics. C'est assez impressionnant, parce que c'est aussi, il y a un côté philosophique, hein, c'est très profond, et Mike s'exprime vraiment absolument dans ses textes, il donne vraiment des détails. And always in the music video, Mike, hein, I saw the lightning that struck humanity. I think this is divine punishment.
Oh, I don't know about that. I mean, but we take a more scientific approach to things, I think, in our camp. But it is kind of like maybe it's a wake up call. We talked about it being maybe the idea that will get us out of it. You know, that lightning bolt of insight, or the you know, that spark of imagination that maybe will get us through, you know, or maybe, as you say, okay, some kind of punishment where it's just like, nah, you're done, like nothing good will come of this, and it just ends there. So, and I mean, that's part of this dystopian idea as well, like it could end at any moment, you know. You know, a solar flare from the sun could kind of wipe out all the electricity, and 2-3 months later we'd be gone. You know, that can happen. Like those are things that are not, you know, just in our imagination. It's actually kind of like a stark reality. And
okay.
So some of these things were kind of interesting to contemplate as well, you mm-hmm. know.
Alors effectivement, dans la vidéo, c'est vrai qu'il y a je trouve qu'il y a un sens religieux, il y a un sens, il se passe quelque chose au milieu, hein, on y voit un peu une humanité et puis on y voit un gros éclair qui frappe cette humanité, quoi. Et je lui ai posé la question, est-ce que c'était une intervention divine? Il me dit, c'est pas, en fait, c'est libre interprétation. Il se passe quelque chose où, il y a une punition, il y a un gros éclair dans le clip qui vient et qui explose à peu près tout, quoi. Et c'est un peu comment il l'explique, c'est un peu le wake up call, c'est un peu le réveil, c'est l'appel à l'humanité, c'est ce réveil là, quoi. Et c'est une partie de son imagination dans lequel il révèle. Et en fait, c'est vraiment très philosophique, hein, c'est assez pointu d'ailleurs. And I think because nowadays I feel like everything is a business, bank, money, war, racism, and no one believes in humanity in anymore. That's I think it's now.
I think I agree. And that's the sad part. Yeah, it's like you can make money out of, you know, horrible opinions.
That's right.
You can say whatever you want and you'll get followers, and that will mean revenue and money for you. So taking a stand and being like, you know, reasonable and well thought through and rational and have a kind of a clear view of things is not interesting. You know, the narrative and the story and the storytelling is more important. And so, yeah. Like blatant lying or just factual errors is more appealing than reality. And I get that. I mean, reality can be rough, you know, so you're looking for something else, you're looking for an alternative narrative, alternative kind of motivation. Mm-hmm. And that's all you need, you know, and then yeah, you go about your day. But that can be very, very dangerous and destructive and first and foremost, extremely scary, because what else, you know, like what's the next step, you know, if you kind of abandon your part of your morals, or you abandon your sense of kind of critical thinking and you just go with it, then what else can happen to you? Like, what else are you going to be fooled by or deceived by, you know? Mm-hmm. So that's really scary. And if you just trust in the almighty dollar, you know, and that means like the richest guy who tells you the biggest lie is the one you listen to. Mm-hmm. And that's super scary.
Ok, alors effectivement, en ce moment, nous vivons de pas mal de choses assez moches, hein, quand effectivement la guerre, la banque, les monnaies, le racisme, etc., la politique, tout est mélangé. Et lui, il pose la question, what is the next step? Quel sera le prochain niveau? Effectivement, on vit dans un monde très dangereux à l'heure actuelle, où les histoires sont très mensongères, et donc il faut faire très attention en ce moment à ne pas croire effectivement tout ce qui sort des médias, etc. Donc il est très focus, hein. And I think with this new album, Dark Tranquility goes to the heart of the human condition. Do you agree?
I mean that's an ongoing struggle, like to really fully understand it, and as you say, like get to the heart of the human condition is something that I'm deeply fascinated by, and maybe this is the darkest trip into the heart of darkness so far. But I mean, trying to understand and trying to kind of reckon with it and to have a healthy relationship with the darker side of us, it's probably a good thing. Just knowing why we are doing things instead of just reacting, it's probably a healthy thing. And I try to practice that, you know. Mm-hmm. But also try and I guess I've always tried to somehow understand as much as possible about, you know, human condition. Why do we feel and think the way that we do? Why do we act the way that we do? And I figure like, yeah, it's just humanity, but now it's also stupidity and ignorance and kind of wanton ignorance, like where you choose not to know or understand. You just, it's too much work. I'll choose this truth that's closer to my idea, or closer to what I believe, mm-hmm. To be real. And you can't choose. Like there are things that empirical facts, just, you know, stop it, you know. And so I mean, the more you get into it, the more depressing it gets, I suppose.
Effectivement, en ce moment, hein, quand je le répète encore, on vit effectivement des moments assez difficiles. Donc, et avec cet album, la question était est-ce que Dark Tranquility, avec le nouvel album, va tout droit, parle, enfin, va au cœur de la condition humaine. Et lui, il pense qu'effectivement, on est, oui, ils vont dedans. Effectivement, c'est aussi, il parle de stupidité, il parle d'ignorance, il parle de pensée, de quoi faire. Effectivement, il parle de d'actes. Il exprime beaucoup de choses en tout cas, et puis de darkness. Truc, comme il dit, de mauvais présages, de sens très proche de ce qui prétend en tout cas. Et dans cet album, il y a des titres effectivement, hein, qui sont assez sombres et dont les paroles sont vraiment néfastes. Et c'est exactement, enfin en tout cas, c'est vraiment dans cette condition humaine là. En direct ce soir dans 213 Rock, Vinyl Times, The Classic Rock Radio, Mr. Mike Stanley of a Dark Tranquility. My Unforgivable is a new track typically in the vibe of a Dark Tranquility style. The feedback from your fans on YouTube are very excellent. I read some great comments. Wow.
Yeah, it was very encouraging and amazing to see. And we knew that we were onto something that kind of, brought back memories of early days, or maybe, you know, the mid 90s or stuff like that, where we just wanted to scream and we were so frustrated and angry and we just needed to get things out of our systems and to play as fast as possible. Just was the greatest thing in the world, you know. Mm-hmm. And getting back to that felt good. And I mean, Joakim plays drums on this album, is such a beast, and so we can do anything. So it was an exercise in kind of like how far can we take this, and it's a song about displacement and how horrible it must be to be driven away from your home, never to be able to return, and that goes for a lot of places in the world right now. So I was just, I felt, you know, helpless and I don't know. You know, here in our, you know, nice and easy part of the world in the Nordics, where we don't understand like the misery of others just because we'd never experience anything like that. And it was just, like the helpless frustration was the cause for this song, and it feels great to perform it every night. We do it, we played it like 7-8 times so far, and it's just feels great to just fucking go all out with a song like that. I really love it.
Mm-hmm. Effectivement, qu'ils ont joué ce titre en concert, le Unforgivable, on a déjà 7 à peu près à 8 fois, donc c'est vrai bien. Et puis ce titre, c'est aussi un petit peu un retour aux sources, hein, comme à l'époque, effectivement, des débuts, enfin début et milieu de carrière de Dark Tranquility. C'est un old style aussi qui revient. C'est aussi une force, hein, avec un blast beat, avec une batterie incroyable, avec des grosses guitares, une voix, ouais, screamed. En tout cas, c'est du old style qui est retourné. Et puis en même temps, c'est aussi les conditions. En tout cas, on voit à travers le clip, hein, le groupe, comment il tourne, tourbus, etc. La vie de tous les jours. Sans jamais parfois savoir quand est-ce qu'ils vont rentrer à la maison, c'est un peu leur vie, quoi. I think there is a paradox between the lyrics and the music video, because the lyrics are very harsh. Unforgivable betrayal in the hour of our need.
Yeah, and the music video is basically just when you're there to kind of fully communicate that kind of stuff. And I think for me, the greatest joy that we get out of this band and being in a band and performing in front of a crowd is that you can be there and you can scream about these things that are horrible to you, and it's been something that's on your mind always. And then you can see in the eyes of the people who listen that they get it. They have been feeling the same thing, or they understand, and it becomes a conversation about something that we have felt together, you know, as a metal community kind of thing. And it's the greatest kind of relief for me. When that happens, you know, when you get nights or, you know, shows where you feel that the audience is right there with us and they understand it, even though maybe they haven't read the lyrics or they don't understand exactly what I'm talking about, but they get the message, or they get the expression, or they get what we're, you know, fundamentally is trying to say. And I love that when that happens. There's nothing better. So of course there is maybe a paradox between like the seriousness of the lyrics, but also the kind of the joyful nature of the video. But for me, it's kind of the same. It's this relief when you find people who get it, you know, or understand or share your concerns.
Ok, alors effectivement, j'ai bien touché, hein. Il y a un paradoxe effectivement entre le clip et les paroles. Pour lui, la plus grande joie effectivement, c'est d'apporter, c'est de faire toujours continuer le groupe, effectivement, d'être toujours là en 2024, toujours parler expressément avec la metal community. C'était ça important avec toutes ces nuits, ces concerts, ces tournées effectivement. Et puis d'avoir un message et puis d'avoir une expression, de parler avec les fans. C'est ça qu'il souhaite en tout cas, d'être toujours en communication avec les personnes qui sont autour du groupe et les fans. C'est ça qui était très important. And Mike, Not Nothing on the track is very special because you sing about the need to find a way for humanity and leave a history in the face in the immensity of the universe. Wow, this is the niche.
I mean, it's existential dread at its finest, right? It's just about like the lengths we will go to just to prove to ourselves that we have a purpose, right? We'll do anything just to show that, yeah, there's something, you know, this is important. You know, it's not only important to me, it's important, period, you know. And I think it's fascinating, the stories we tell ourselves and each other just so that we justify our existence, right? Because the alternative is unfathomable, you know. If we start realizing just how insignificant we are, then nothing will get done, you know. So it's a matter of like finding that purpose or that little sliver of meaning and hold on to it, you know, no matter what it is. And yes, as insignificant as you might feel sometimes, you still you have a certain purpose to someone or something, you know. Mm-hmm. So
alors,
I wouldn't say it's a hopeful song, but it's more kind of like about the reality of it.
Yeah, but it's very difficult for to explain Not Nothing song because the lyrics are very, very so difficult. Because there, it's a lot of the topic is very philosophic. I said.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah,
but I think it's easy to relate to though, even though maybe it's
yeah, I can no problem, I can do it. Effectivement, que Mike Stan s'attaque effectivement au paradoxe, au sentiment de l'insignifiance en fait, hein, avec ce pouvoir de l'infini en fait, et il pose la question effectivement sur le mécanisme de survie, sur cette dualité qui reflète la lutte humaine commune avec le besoin de trouver un sens et de laisser une trace malgré l'immensité écrasante de l'univers. C'est-à-dire que l'univers est tellement énorme, est-ce que nous sommes seuls? Et là, il pose la question effectivement, nous sommes une toute petite planète par rapport à une exoplanète, par rapport à tout ce qu'il peut y avoir dans ce monde incroyable, quoi. Est-ce que nous allons laisser une trace, quelque chose pour d'autres civilisations? Donc il pose la question effectivement, et les paroles sur le titre Not Nothing et sont vraiment géniales, elles sont vraiment très très bonnes. I said the lyrics of the Not Nothing are pretty cool because it means a lot of questions.
Yeah. It's about that doubt, I think, you know. It's like you're questioning yourself, you're questioning your motives.
That's right.
Your place in the world, right?
Effectivement qu'on se pose beaucoup de questions. So Mike, just before the end, can we consider the albums Atoma, Moment and End Time Signals as a trilogy?
I don't know. No, okay. not really. I think this is the beginning of maybe a new trilogy or the beginning of something. I think this is very different from Moment and Atoma.
Okay.
In many, many ways, like maybe lyrically it ties together, but musically I think this is a bit, yeah, it's separate.
Okay.
At least in my mind. Maybe I'll look back at it in a different way, but for now.
Alors j'ai posé la question si Atoma, Moment et End Time Signals hein, pouvait être une trilogie. Il me dit non, c'est trop différent effectivement. Alors peut-être dans les paroles, mais il dit là il y a peut-être avec End Time Signals, le nouvel album, il y a peut-être une nouvelle trilogie avec le nouvel album effectivement. Retrouvez Dark Tranquility en concert à Paris le 10 novembre prochain du côté de la Machine du Moulin Rouge, le 11 novembre à Toulouse au Bikini avec les Moonspell, Wolfheart et Erase. So you will be in France for two special shows at the La Machine, yes, le Moulin Rouge. November 10th and in Toulouse at the Bikini, November 11th. Wow.
Two of my favorite places. Oh, it's going to be awesome.
Oh yeah. Donc effectivement, ces places favorites effectivement. So Mike, thank you very much for this live interview. Do you have a message for the audience tonight, please?
No, I just can't wait to see you in Paris and in Toulouse. And we're coming back to France in the beginning of next year as well for a longer tour throughout France. So if you can't make it to do any of those shows, you'll get a second chance. We're going to announce it pretty soon. But we're dying to play these new songs for you guys and hope the album is as good as we feel it is for everybody else.
Okay. End Time Signals. L'album sera disponible disponible le 16 août prochain via le label Century Media Records, 213 Rock, Vinyl Times, The Classic Rock Radio. Continuons toujours avec le titre Not Nothing of Dark Tranquility on 213 Rock, Vinyl Times, Classic Rock Radio.
Still lost in time.